lot of finishes right here.
And a couple more to come, right?
Remember, I've got 50 buckles.
That's new material, Chris.
Yeah. Well, I have to have new material. Otherwise, I'd start saying, whatever you do, don't start thinking about those 135 miles of scorching roadway in front of you.
It's something about that valley. It just keeps calling you back. You want to get out here and experience it. It's just surreal. You know, having dreams come true every year.
It's like once you start running ultra marathons, this is the ultimate. This is the one you want to do. This is the one you're striving for.
Man must do this race one time in his life, I think.
It's really happening. I've been waiting a long time for this, so gotta be careful what you wish for.
Stay focused here at the lowest point of the race. It's all uphill from here.
Why do I run? I'm not quite sure why I run.
Because it brings me joy.
Even if I don't love running, I always love how I feel after running.
I've tried to write a couple books to explain why we run, and I still don't think I've nailed it.
I have no idea why I run, you know? People always want to know, especially when you do ultras. Why do you do it? And there isn't really a good answer. It's something in the core that makes you want to do it.
Is what I do, you know? It's part of my life. It's part of who I am.
Looking good. Remember, work in your own race, buddy. Not now. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Ah!
I run because, why do I run, Jim? It's the only way to offset all the eating and drinking.
These people keep chasing me, and I have to get away.
Running out here is probably one of the toughest ways that you can challenge yourself.
Really, I've turned 60, and this is my sixth time to run Badwater, and I just love it. If you've ever come and do it once, this kind of gets in your blood. Out here in the desert, so it keeps bringing you back. Every time I ran it, I've always said, I'll never do it again. So here I am.
Every year that I do Badwater, I say, I am never gonna do this race again. And here I am back for a 10th go at it. So I haven't figured that one out either.
I fell in love. I saw the first pictures and magazines and videos and just knew I was gonna be born to run this race someday.
It's just a challenge, and it's not just running, it's your crew, it's everybody working together.
Badwater, in my opinion, is as the biggest ultra there is. It's like the Olympics of ultra running.
I felt pretty good all day, but I do feel better at sundown. Way better.
Somebody said it's more fun this way, so I just, I figured just keep going. Last year we got married 11 days after the race.
Congratulations.
Thanks. Still here a year later.
How do you feel?
Good, man. Good.
Do you have a strategy at this point?
Yeah, run.
Deep into a race at mile 125, my inspiration to keep going is trying to reach a point of nirvana where it doesn't matter whether I'm running another 5 miles or 10 miles or 50 miles.
I don't know. You just know that you got to finish, and you got, I don't know, but somehow we manage every time.
Knowing that there were people who were out there who were watching me and believing in me the entire time and that I couldn't let them down.
Hey, wait a minute.
Yeah.
Wait a minute. This number is for you. For next year.
Yeah! Woo!
You know, to me, Badwater's a journey, and I think that the fact that I'm back here for a 10th go at it says it all. You know, reaching the finish line, everyone thinks there's so much glory in reaching the finish line. To me, there's been disappointment when I've reached the finish line because the journey's over.
He does this for the Valley of the Moon Children's Home, so a lot of times reminding him why he's out here and that he gets to go back and talk to the kids about what he did is a lot of what motivates him to get across this.
And it's a huge deal for them. I'm telling them that you can do anything. Anything's possible. Anything. If I can do this, then they can do anything.
And the champion of the 6 a.m. wave.
Woo!
Yep.
Awesome.
Yep, and a 70-plus record that'll never be broken.
And you know what?
I'll put any money on that.
It's just all about fun, this event, isn't it? Fun now, fun later. Not fun now, fun later. And the other one that I've only ever encountered when I've got caught is fun now and not fun later. And we discovered that yesterday morning, that fun now and not fun later refers to going out too fast.